When you hear to this rhythmic word, all that we imagine is people, people, and more people. It attracts more than 150 million people from all over the world. It is considered the most prominent holy gathering in the planet Earth. Why do so many people come to this place? This question brings different answers. But the belief is that the holy rivers, the Ganga, Yamuna, and the mythical Saraswati, are blessed with mystical strength. A dip in Sangam will emit all your sins and help attain moksha, or salvation from the cycle of life and death. An eternal life free of sins is the promise that comes attached with the magnificent event called Kumbh Mela. The normal Kumbh Mela is held every 3 years. The Earth Kumbh Mela is held every 6 years at Haridwar and Prayagraj. While the Purna Kumbh Mela takes place every 12 years at 4 places, Prayagraj, previously known as Allahabad, Haridwar, Ujjain and Nasik, based on planetary movements. The Mahakumbh Mela is celebrated at Prayagraj once in 144 years or after 12 Purna Kumbh Mela. In the course of this documentary, you will be amazed by the rhythmic chanting of mantras, the heart-rendering dance of Naga sadhus, and most importantly, history behind the entire event. This year in Prayagraj of Uttar Pradesh hosted Earth Kumbh Mela, the world's largest religious gathering to accommodate magnanimous crowd of more than 150 million people. The city is lit up with the twinkling lights trying to showcase the essence of the Kumbh. A makeshift city constructed at Prayagraj will accommodate more than 5.5 times the population of Australia and is created to celebrate cosmic consciousness in the practices of Hinduism. The Kumbh area is a temporary settlement of tents made on the flood plains of Ganges and Yamuna River, which are vastly sprawled over 39 square kilometers. In a span of just few months, the city of Prayagraj has got 264 new streets, there are 10 new flyovers, and several roads have been rebuilt. 300 kilometers long road and 22 pontoon bridges are also constructed. 40,000 street lights have also been put up to avoid any kind of inconvenience to the pilgrims. 122,000 toilets were built for the Kumbh, which has been registered by the Guinness World Record as the biggest sanitation drive in the world. Legend has it that in the mythological times, during a waging war between the demigods and demons for the possession of Amrit of eternal life, a few drops of it had fallen on 4 places that are today known as Prayagraj, Haridwar, Ujjain and Nasik. It is believed that these drops gave mystical powers to these places. This Mela is held on the dates when the water of these sacred rivers are said to be turned into a nectar. The auspicious dates are calculated according to zodiac positions of Jupiter, the Sun and the Moon.
Om Bhur Bhuvah Svah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yo Na Prachodayat Om Bhur
The most powerful draws of the Mela are the Nagas, the naked sadhus. The rituals performed during Mela are worth witnessing. Hindu Dharma advocates peaceful life taking into cognizant human relation with nature. The cycle of birth and death is only medium for the soul to temporarily reside in the human body to elevate the conscious level to reach God.
Sugandhim pushti vardhanam Urvarukmiv bandhana Mrityo mukshiya mamrita
Sadhus who practice big conscious tasks take penance to an impossible level, unimaginable for ordinary people. Who are Naga Sadhus? In Sanskrit, Naga also means mountain. People residing in and around mountains are called Nagas. The history of Naga sadhus is ancient. During past invasions, there were a series of attacks on the Sanatan Dharma and Hindu structures. At that point of time, a massive exercise was carried over by Naga sadhus to organize their strength and form akhadas so that they all fight under one saffron flag to protect Hindu culture and Vedic tradition of India. They raised weapon-wielding brigades to repel the foreign invasions and named them Akhadas. This movement was initiated by Sri Adi Shankaracharya, who was a great scholar in the 8th century AD. He formed several Akhadas who had fearless yogis to fight bravely with the attackers. There is a total of 14 Akhadas with around 500,000 sannyasi members. Juna Akhada by far the most important order of sadhus in India today. In that, vast majority are Naga sadhus. Only few fortunate become Naga sadhus. The strongest commitment makes a Naga. The process to achieve Naga position is very difficult and the exercises are so hard that it cannot be compared to the most strenuous preparations of any army around the world. Naga sadhus were equipped with various weapons and weaponry skills to successfully protect temples from invaders.
काम करो लो मो अहंकार को छोड़ दे हम लोग सन्यासी बनते नागा बाबा हमारी परंपरा हम सेना है सनातन धर्म की सेना है हम लोग हाँ अपने हिंदू धर्म की रक्षा के लिए अपने सनातन धर्म के लिए हमको शंकराचार्य ने नागा बनाए हैं आज से 5,000 वर्ष पहले आज के नागा नहीं हम लोग 5,000 वर्ष पहले आज गुरु शंकराचार्य महाराज
There are few rules and rituals of becoming Naga sadhus. The first being strong celibacy and penance. A person who is interested in pursuing a life of Naga sadhu should have complete control over his lust, sexual feelings, and erotic libido. Mentally, a person should renounce material wealth and desire for worldly things. The permission to become Naga is known as Diksha, but there are many other conditions which need to be fulfilled before this permission is given. Second is serving to God, people and country. A person who attains control over his senses is of no use if he does not love God, people and country. Serving and following orders of his guru helps the person in removing self-ego. Selfless faith sows the seed of developing loving human nature to protect people and country.
और कुंभ मेला जरूर को कुंभ मेले पर जरूर स्नान का अमृत धारा है यहाँ। यह जहाँ भी कुंभ लगता है यह अमृत होता है, तो आदमी के काम करो लोभ मोह अहंकार सब छूट जाते हैं, सब गंगा जी में चले जाते हैं, सतोगुणी आदमी बन जाता है। सतोगुण रजोगुण तमोगुण ये सब को पिता सतोगुण के अंदर इंसान आ जाता है यह कुंभ मेले का स्नान करने से। यह कुंभ का यही विचार होता है कि आदमी जो है ना जितना भी अहंकार कुछ भी होता है यहाँ सब छूट जाता है कुंभ मेले पर।
Next is rites. It is essential to perform last rites, considering himself dead for the family and society. It is like a new birth of a person in a new world of Nagas. The last rites are performed by the individual himself, relinquishing his connection with the family members and friends. After this, Guru gives him a new name and identity. Next is renouncing clothes. Naga sadhus cannot wear clothes. They can wear a single saffron cloth that is not to cover the entire body. They can only rub ashes on their body. A Naga sadhu has to wear Rudraksha mala on his neck. Next comes having one meal a day. A Naga sadhu can just eat once in a day. He cannot make choices. He need to eat what is offered to him. A Naga can sleep only on Mother Earth. At the most, he can cover the ground with a piece of cloth, but cannot use cot, couch, or bed to sleep. Most important one is Guru Mantra. After attaining Diksha, Guru gives a mantra to the Naga. His entire life revolves around this Guru Mantra. He must completely trust Guru and perform penance with the mantra given to him.
Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Nama. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Nama.
The last and final is secluded life. A Naga sadhu cannot reside in cities or thickly populated town. He has to take shelter in places which are far away from ordinary people. Naga sadhus undergo deep pain and tiresome process to test their self-control. They elevate and enhance their austerity, testing their limits to the extreme. During Kumbh Mela, you might find hundreds of such Naga sadhus penancing in their shelter or in the open.
The reason I'm here is because first of all, India is my home now, and I think this is part of my spiritual path that I'm taking. So I'm just answering a calling to be here.
आधुनिक पीरियड में 300-400 सालों के दौरान ऐसा कुंभ मेला कभी न हुआ था और न शायद भविष्य में हो।
There are also women Naga sadhvis. In recent years, there are many women who have become Naga sadhus. They enroll in akhada and undergo the same tiresome process to become Naga sadhvi. Impressed with the culture and tradition of connecting with God Shiva, thereby serving people, women from several countries flocked to akhadas to become Naga sadhvis. For the first time in Kumbh Mela, members of transgender community called Kinnar Akhada took part in the royal bath on the opening day of Mega Fair. They say this participation is about mainstream society accepting us. The Creator is within us, and once we die, we will go back to Him. Our doors are open for all. The acceptance of the third gender is remarkable in conservative society like ours. Common people use their body to extract pleasure. They lead life inside out. So all of their energy is exhausted by end of day. They have to sleep to regain their energy somehow. It is said that Siddha Naga Sadhus of Himalayas use their body to raise the level of consciousness to highest order. They do not sleep. They keep their consciousness at a state which is way beyond sleep and dream state of common people. They use vital energy of universe to meditate for rest of their life. Hatha yogis can absorb immense pain and take it to the level that their body's immune system becomes torture and disease proof. Adorning body is part of ritual of Naga sadhus. They wear different types of spiritual things all over their body to feel close to God Shiva. Ash keeps their body safe and unaffected from environmental pollution and is like a second skin for the Nagas. They rub their body with ash while portraying themselves in the form of Shiva. Naga takes good interest in decorating their forehead with tilak. Tilak signifies identity and strength. Naga sadhus like to wear marigold flowers around their neck. Naga sadhus believe that Rudraksha came from the tears of God Shiva, and wearing it is a blessing of Shiva. Rudraksha mala is made more powerful with the mantras and year of Siddha process. After Siddhi, the original Rudraksha mala protects the Nagas as it glorifies and enhances the aura in and around them. Many Naga sadhus prefer wearing jewels which correspond to Navagrahas to get in sync with the nine planets. The science of Vedic astrology, which revolves around the Navagrahas, is also thousands of years old. It is said that a yogi with long hair is more energetic, tireless, powerful, and fearless. Hair is a natural conductor of our body's electromagnetic energy. Coiling hair causes induction. The science of coiling wires in electronics comes from ancient Hindu science of interlocking hair in the coil formed to induce energy in the body. Coiling hair enhances electromagnetic energy. That is also one of the reasons that yogis and Nagas never get affected from heat, cold, or change in weather. They are always healthy and strong. Naga sadhus take good care of their hair. They clean it with the typical black soil, soak it in the morning under sunlight, and rejuvenate their body energy, extracting power from the sun using air as a receptor. Naga sadhus grow long beard as it makes face muscles stronger, and they act as a receptor of positive energy when Surya Namaskar is performed in the river, which is salutation to sun. The bathing of saints and their disciples of akhadas on the prescribed days at the beginning of the Kumbh Mela is called Rajyogi Snan or Shahi Snan. Shahi Snan of the Kumbh Mela begins at morning 4. Saints and their disciples take out a weapon-wielding procession which is flanked by a huge crowd. The locals decorate the path where the procession is going to be carried with rangolis and flower petals. One by one, the akhadas consisting of their saints and disciples proceed on the route towards the place of the Shahi Snan, usually accompanied by camels, horses amidst playing of music. Some saints sit on the elephants and few on the chariots where they use tractor trolleys. Various musical instruments are played during this time with slogans such as Har Har Mahadev and Har Har Gange. Thousands of naked sadhus with holy ash smeared on the body wear garlands, holding weapons and flags for the absolute devotion to that one moment in water. First preference is given to akhadas for holy bath in the Kumbh Mela. Shahi Snan of the weapon-wielding sadhus is considered the biggest ritual in the Kumbh Mela. Until they have their Shahi Snan, the devotees do not bathe. After a holy bath, the procession of sadhu have darshan of the temples in the vicinity and return to their place of residence. The devotees stand on both the sides of the road, put up arches and flags, and traditionally welcome the sadhus for their darshan. The tradition of welcoming the sadhus after this holy bath has been nurtured for many years. The devotees throng the roads to seek blessings of sadhus when they return to their akhadas after the holy bath. There is a deeply enrooted feeling of devotion and faith flowing in the veins of devotees returning back from Kumbh. We are all visitors to this time, this place. We are just passing through. Our purpose here is to observe, to learn, to grow, to love, and then we return home.